Another explosion rocks Austin. Hours after police chief pleaded for attacks to stop, three package bombs left on doorsteps have exploded in less than 2 weeks in Austin, killing two people, wounding two others, and leaving investigators searching for any possible explanation or motive. All of the victims were minorities. Austin residents in Southwest Austin were asked to hunker down in their homes overnight after an explosion rocked the area Sunday and injured two men. Authorities worked to determine if the blast was another in a string of bombings that have left multiple people dead and wounded in the Texas capital. The two men were hospitalized with serious, but non-life-threatening injuries, Austin Travis County M said. Austin Police Chief Brian Manley wouldn't say whether the explosion was linked to the string of package bombs that have fueled fears for more than 2 weeks. Dozens of law enforcement officers, including FBI agents, flooded the neighborhood of single-family brick homes to investigate after the reported blast about 8:30 p.m. Court. Neighbors reported homes rattling after the explosion. One of those injured had nails in their leg, according to KVUE-TV. Manley urged residents within a half mile of the blast on Don Song Drive to stay inside until at least morning so law enforcement could clear the area. He said a backpack was found and authorities were working to deem it safe. He didn't offer any details on the explosion or whether it was tied to any of the other incidents. "We simply don't know a lot at this point," Manley said. "Stay in your residence. Don't touch anything that looks suspicious." Earlier Sunday, Manley held a televised news conference and made a plea to the person behind the attack. "We hope this person or persons is watching and will reach out to us before anyone else is injured or anyone else is killed," he said. "We assure you, we are listening and we want to understand what brought you to this point, and we want to listen to you. So please call us." Manley also announced a reward was increased to $100,000 for information that leads to an arrest in the case. That, along with an award from the governor's office, would bring the total reward to $115,000. Each of the attacks have been similar. A plain cardboard box with standard shipping labels is left on a doorstep. Each had a bomb inside. Two people have been killed in the attacks and another two injured. If Sunday's incident is tied to the string of attacks, it would make the fourth bombing in a little more than 2 weeks. Police initially raised the possibility of a hate crime because victims in the first two explosions were black. The third apparent target was Hispanic. So it's not clear whether that pattern is intentional because a motive is still unknown. The first package exploded March 2nd, killing Anthony Steffenhaus, 39, when he picked up a package on the front porch of his North Austin home. The second bomb went off before 7 a.m. on March 12th inside a home in East Austin. Police said Raylan Mason, 17, brought the package inside the kitchen and was opening it alongside his mother when it exploded. Mason died, and his mother was hospitalized. The third blast came a short time later in a neighborhood south of downtown. A 75-year-old Hispanic woman picked up a package on her front porch when it exploded, seriously injuring her. Manley said she remains hospitalized with life-threatening injuries and authorities are not publicly identifying her. Manley said this type of investigation and the number of resources on it is unprecedented in Austin's history. He said investigators know the incidents were meant to send a message but are unsure what it is. The explosions occurred in Austin as the popular South by Southwest festival, which attracts global leaders in business, technology, music, and film, is occurring in the city and children in Texas public schools are on spring break. More than 50 agents from the FBI, ATF, and other agencies are assisting in the investigation. There are agencies at all levels of government that are out here and involved right now, Mayor Steve Adler told KVUE-TV.